إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالًا كثيرًا ونساءً، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله. Indeed, the most truthful of speech and the best of words are the words of Allah. وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the best guidance is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وشر الأمور محدثاتها. And the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent into this religion of ours. وكل محدثة بدعة. And everything we newly invent in this religion of ours is an innovation. وكل بدعة ضلالة. And every innovation is misguidance and it leads astray. وكل ضلالة في النار. And every going astray, every misguidance is in the hellfire. ثم أما بعد. My dear brothers in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gave us the virtue of dhikr. He gave us a great gift in being able to remember Allah at all times so that we could get reward and praise our Creator and give peace to our hearts. Listen to the messages of dhikr that Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam brought forth as examples from the Quran and the Sunnah. Allah says, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَطْمَئِنُّ قُلُوبُهُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبُ. Allah says what means those who believe in the oneness of Allah, in the Tawheed that Islam brought, the pure monotheism, and whose hearts find rest in the remembrance of Allah. Indeed, verily, in the remembrance of Allah do the hearts find rest. ثُمَّ قَالَ اللَّهُ فَإِذَا قُضِيَتِ الصَّلَاةُ فَانْتَشِرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَابْتَغُوا مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. And Allah says what means, and when the prayer has been concluded, disperse in the land and seek from the bounty of Allah and remember Allah often so that you may succeed. Success tied to the one who's constantly remembering his Lord and his Creator. ثم قال الله أتل ما أوحي إليك من الكتاب وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. And Allah said in the Quran what means, recite, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what has been revealed to you of the book, and establish the prayer. Indeed, in the establishment of the prayer, it is what will help to prohibit immorality and wrongdoing, and the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is greater, and Allah knows that which you do. ثم قال الله يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تلهكم أموالكم ولا أولادكم عن ذكر الله ومن يفعل ذلك فأولئك هم الخاسرون. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says what means, O you who believe, let not your properties nor your children divert you from the remembrance of Allah. You would get so upset with them, so mad at them, you would get furious with your children sometimes if they diverted you from the wealth, from the money. Yet on a daily basis, we see money, property, wealth, the pursuit of that, and the family members diverting us from the remembrance of Allah. Whoever does that, they will be in a state of loss. They will be of the losers. ثُمَّ قَالَ اللَّهُ فَاذْكُرُونِ يَذْكُرُكُمْ وَاشْكُرُوا لِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ. And Allah said in the Quran what means, therefore remember me by praying, by glorifying me, by making tasbih and tahmid and tahleel and takbir. Remember me and glorify me, and I will remember you. And be grateful to me for my countless favors, the ones you could never count all of them, and never be ungrateful to me. ثم قال الله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اذكروا الله ذكرا كثيرا وسبحوه بكرة وأصيلا. And Allah said, what means, O you who believe, remember Allah with much remembrance and glorify His praises in the morning and the afternoon. In the morning and the afternoon, meaning clarified more with the next ayah, we will mention. ثم قال الله فاصبر على ما يقولون وسبح بحمد ربك قبل طلوع الشمس وقبل الغروب. And Allah says, what means, so bear with patience, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, all that they say, and glorify and praise your Lord. يعني for relief, for help, for aid, for comfort, the comfort of your heart. Glorify and praise your Lord before the rising of the sun and before its setting. يعني after Fajr prayer, before sunrise, or some of the ulama say after sunrise is okay, and after Asr prayer, before sunset, but after some of the ulama have said after Maghrib is okay. Azkar al-Sabah wal-Masa, the remembrances of the mornings and the evening, the remembrances after every prayer, the remembrances with every situation we face. Sometimes when it's windy, or you hear thunder, or there's heavy rain, there's ad'iya, there's adhkar for all of these situations. But our tongues are wet with ghibah. They're wet with backbiting, they're wet with namima, they're wet with slandering, they're wet with kadhib, with lying. They're wet with spreading false tales. Qawl al-zur wa shahadat al-zur. To witness false things, to speak false words, and utter false claims. Instead of being wet with the remembrance of Allah. My brothers in Islam, regularly we should be saying these. You want protection from Allah, with Allah, from evil, from harm, from envy, from the evil eye, then it's the adhkar, the remembrance of Allah, in the morning and the evening. So simple for you to learn. If you go to the website, there's even a series of many of those. Very light on the tongue, easy to memorize. And inshallah, we will be bringing more to you so you can memorize them. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he said, if you could hear the sound of the pens of the angels who write down those who remember Allah, if we could hear that pen scribbling on the paper, your name being written, you witnessed by the angels that Allah created to only obey Him, while we were created to choose, but we chose to obey Allah and make remembrance of and do remembrance of Him. If you could hear the sound of those angels' pens, you would die out of joy. You would die out of joy. So my brothers in Islam, let us look furthermore at why dhikr is so elevated. An Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu qal, qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, yaqul Allah azza wa jal. So this is a hadith Qudsi. The words are coming from Allah, related by our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a hadith. Yaqul Allah azza wa jal, ana inda dhanna abdi, wa ana ma'ahu hina yadhkurni, fa in dhakarani في نفسه ذكرته في نفسي وإن ذكرني في ملأ ذكرته في ملأ خير منه وإن اقترب إلي شبرا تقربت إليه ذراعا وإن اقترب إلي ذراعا اقتربت إليه باعا وإن آتاني يمشي آتيته هرولا رواه مسلم. This hadith Qudsi, we find it in Sahih Muslim. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I am as my servant thinks of me. I am as my servant thinks of me. And I am with him as long as he remembers me. He or she. Okay? We're just using he for the simplicity.
And if my servant remembers me to himself, I remember him to myself.
And if he remembers me in a gathering, then I will mention him and remember him in a gathering much greater than that gathering he's in. Yani bragging about you to the malaika, to the angels. And if he draws near to me, the span of a palm, I will draw near to him the span of a cubit. And if he draws near to me the span of a cubit, I draw near to him by a space covered by two arms lengths. And if he walks towards me, I will rush towards him. Rawahu Muslim. All of this coming towards Allah, praising our Lord, having Allah remember us, mention us to the angels, brag that these humans that I created that had free will chose to leave off their desires and worship me and praise me. They remember me, so Allah will remember you. What greater gift Can we also have in this dunya then being blessed with this deen to also have Allah remember us because we remembered Him? To have us in His heart because we have Him in our hearts. And we're constantly on that. عن عائشة رضي الله عنها قالت كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يذكر الله تعالى على كل أحيانه. And عائشة رضي الله عنها, she narrated in the hadiths in Sahih Muslim and other books, عائشة said that the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم used to remember Allah, the Most High, at all times. He was always remembering Allah. Always, always remembering His Creator. Thanking Him and praising Him for the blessings and the gifts. Making istighfar to Him. Always glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ثُمَّ قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ أَحَبُّ الْأَعْمَالِ إِلَى اللَّهِ أَن تَمُوتَ وَلِسَانُكَ رَطْبٌ مِّن ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. And the Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said that the most loved action to Allah is to die and your heart was wet with the remembrance of Allah. This hadith is in the collection of Ibn Hibban, and Shaykh al-Albani, he authenticated it. The most beloved of deed is to die and your tongue was one that constantly remembered Allah, was moist with the remembrance of Allah. It moved so much remembering Allah at all times, laying down, in bed, when you awake, when you're startled, when you're happy, throughout the day, in your cars, wherever you may be going, every situation, before you even enter the restroom, you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seek refuge from the evils within that restroom. This is the beauty of our deen. The most beloved action, the one whose tongue is wet with the remembrance of Allah. ثُمَّ قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ أَلَا أُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِخَيْرِ أَعْمَالِكُمْ وَأَزْكَاهَا عِنْدَ مَلِيكِكُمْ وَأَرْفَعُهَا فِي دَرَجَاتِكُمْ وَخَيْرٌ لَكُمْ مِنْ إِنْفَاقِ الذَّهَبِ وَالْوَرَقِ وَخَيْرٌ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَنْ تَلْقُوا عُدُوَّكُمْ فَتَدْرِبُوا عَنَاقَهُمْ وَيَدْرِبُونَ عَنَاقَكُمْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi in this hadith, which is Hassan in the Sunan of Tirmidhi, he said, shall I not inform you of the best of actions, the most pure of the heart with your Lord, the most pure with your Lord, the most lofty in level, better than giving gold and paper and money in charity, and better than your meeting your enemy while you hit their necks and they hit yours, meaning it brings you to your death. What is better than even that is just dhikrillah. And it takes no energy from you. Again, our tongue will move to make an extra dollar. Our tongue will move to spread false tales. Our tongues will move to lie or to cheat or to gain something extra in this dunya. And all you have to do is remember Allah. Do dhikr with your tongue daily throughout the day. And you will have elevated levels higher than the one who loses his battle in jihad. This is the elevation that dhikr Allah brings. ثُمَّ قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ إِنَّ الدُّنْيَا مَلْعُونَةٌ مَلْعُونٌ مَا فِيهَا إِلَّا ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَمَا وَالَاهُ وَعَالِمًا أَوْ مُتَعَلِّمًا. رواه الترمذي. وهذا حديث حسن. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, surely the dunya is cursed. This dunya we're living in is cursed. And everything that is in it is cursed. Except for ذكر الله. Except for the remembrance of Allah. And what supports it. And a scholar or a student. My brothers in Islam, my dear brothers in Islam, and my sisters in Islam, if the brothers maybe close the doors, there might be some sisters in there. Barakallahu
fiik. No one there.
Okay. Remembrance of Allah, dhikrillah, make your tongue wet with it, and you will be granted the highest of rewards by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فدعو الله يغفر لكم ذنوبكم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونصلي ونسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. الحمد لله غافر الذنوب جميعها إلا الشرك به. والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد. My brothers in Islam, Ibad Allah, we were blessed by being on this deen. Allah guided us to something so simple and pure. And many narrations, we can't even share them all, from the ayat to the ahadith. Just the word Alhamdulillah tamla'u al-mizan. The Prophet ﷺ said, just that phrase, Alhamdulillah, will fill your scales. وَسُبْحَانَ وَالْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ تَمْلَانْ أَوْ تَمْلَأُ مَا بَيْنِ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. And Alhamdulillah and Subhanallah, they're so heavy in weight, although they take less than a second to come off your tongue, and they do no harm to your body. They take no effort for you to say them. They bring such peace to your core. Yet guess what? You say it and it fills what's between the heavens and the earth. Simple phrases. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن لله ملائكة يطوفون في الطرق يلتمسون أهل الذكر فإذا وجدوا قوما يذكرون الله تنادوا هلموا إلى حاجتكم قال فيحفون بأجنحتهم إلى السماء الدنيا. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he narrated in this hadith, he said, Allah has some angels who look for those who celebrate His praises, who are constantly making dhikr of Allah on the roads and the paths. The angels, this is their job, to go out, this group, to go out looking for people making dhikr of Allah and remembering Allah. And when they find some people who do that, celebrating the praises of Allah, they call to the other one, come on, come over here. I have found what you've been pursuing and what you've been looking for. So they call the other angels to witness that. He added, then the angels encircle them with their wings up to the sky of the world. قَالَ فَيَسْأَلُهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ وَهُوَ أَعْلَمُ مِنْهُمْ مَا يَقُولُ عِبَادِي قَالُوا يَقُولُونَ يُسَبِّحُونَكَ وَيُكَبِّرُونَكَ وَيُحَمِّدُونَكَ وَيُمَجِّدُونَكَ قَالَ فَيَقُولُ هَلْ رَأَوْنِي قال فيقولون لا والله ما رأوك قال فيقول وكيف لو رأوني قال يقولون لو رأوك كانوا أشد لك عبادة وأشد لك تمجيدا وأكثر لك تسبيحا. Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he added, after those, they're looking after those who celebrate the praises of Allah, and the angels then go back to their Lord after witnessing this. And their Lord asks those angels, even though He has full knowledge already of what they have seen and heard and what they witnessed, He goes and He asks them, what do my servants say? The angels reply, they say Subhanallah, they say Alhamdulillah, they say Allahu Akbar, and they praise you. Allah then says, do they see me? Did they see me for them to do this? This is Bani Adam, the people of desires, the people of loving to follow their lusts. You're telling me they were on the earth abandoning that and remembering me. He will say, did they see me? The angels will reply, no, wallahi, ma ra'awka. They did not see you. By Allah, they did not see you. Allah says, how would it have been if they did see me? If we could see Allah, the angels replies, if they saw you, they would worship you even more devoutly. They would celebrate your glory more deeply. They would declare your freedom from any resemblance to anything more often. Being so blessed, no doubt, with all these blessings and favors from Allah. And we do not worship Him or praise Him or remember Him or glorify Him the way He deserves to be praised. Do we need to really see Him in order to do that the correct way? Is our iman that weak? قَالَ يَقُولْ فَمَا سَأَلُونِي قال يسألونك الجنة يسألونك الجنة قال يقول وهل رأوها قال يقولون لا والله يا رب ما رأوها قال يقول فكيف لو أنهم رأوها قال يقولون لو أنهم رأوها كانوا أشد عليها حرصا وأشد لها طلبا وأعظم فيها رغبة. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم continued to relate. He said, Allah will then say to the angels, what are these slaves asking me for? The angels reply, they ask you for Jannah. Allah says to the angels, did they see Jannah? Again, they're working so hard for something they can't see. The angel will say, no, wallahi, by Allah, O Lord, they do not see it. They did not see it. Allah says, how would it have been if they saw it? The angels say, if they saw it, they would have a greater covetousness for it. They would strive harder than they would for any piece of coins or paper or wealth or anything of this property. They would strive even harder to have it and would seek it with greater zeal, and they would have a greater desire to even get to it. قَالَ فَمِمَّا يَتَعَوَّذُونَ قَالَ يَقُولُونَ مِنَ النَّارِ قال يقول وهل رأوها؟ قال يقولون لا والله ما رأوها. قال يقول فكيف لو رأوها؟ قال يقولون لو رأوها كانوا أشد منها فرارا وأشد لها مخافة. Allah then says, from what do my servants seek refuge from? What do they want me to protect them from? The angels reply, from the hellfire, from Jahannam. Allah says, did they see it? The angels say, Wallahi, no, by Allah, O Lord, they did not see it. Allah says, what would have been their actions if they did see the hellfire? The angels say, if they saw it, they would flee from it with an extreme fleeing. Running away from it like we should run away from every sin that is the desire of our eye when we see it. And they would have extreme fear from it. Like we have extreme fear from the things of this dunya that make us get stuck in fraud. قال فيقول فأشهدكم أني قد غفرت لهم قد غفرت لهم. Then Allah says, I make you a witness that I have forgiven them. The rest of the hadith, for the time's sake, goes on to say that somebody was around these people when they were making their dhikr because they needed a need. They had a need. And even that person will be encircled and given this reward. So it shows us who we should be companions with. It shows us where we should go. It shows us what kind of company we should put ourselves in. Dhikrullah, the remembrance of Allah, the virtue, the greatness of it on our scales on the Day of Judgment, and with content of our hearts facing all that we face in this dunya. May Allah make us from those men and women, believing men and women who remember Allah. Allahumma ighfir lil muslimin wal muslimat wal mu'minin wal mu'minat al ahya' minhum wal amwat innaka anta sami'un qareeb al mujib al da'wat. Allahumma ij'alna min al dhakirin wal dhakirat. Allahumma ij'alna min al dhakirin wal dhakirat. Allahumma ij'alna min al dhakirin wal dhakirat. يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله.